On the Money Watch this morning, if you're swimming in debt, you don't have to drown. There are a few things you can do right now to stop wasting money and get your finances in check. Certified financial planner Joe Brook joins us now to talk more and give us those top tips. Thank you so much, Joe. Appreciate it. Now, the first thing you want to do is an inventory. Is that what you said?
Well, what you don't want to do is go shopping and go come home and find out you own what you already have. And this happens an awful lot. You know, we start accumulating stuff, and before we know it, we bought another blow dryer that we didn't need. We bought tools we didn't need. Maybe we bought shoes we didn't need. Buy a sweater because we already have one like it. So understand what you have, and we accumulate junk, and that's what happens.
You say to play the waiting game. What does that mean?
Well, what you want to do is when you're looking at buying something and you see it in the store, you're about to take it off the shelf, walk around the store a little bit. Take 5, 10, 15 minutes and think about what it's really going to cost you. You know, if you're going to spend $20, $40, $100, think about what that can mean for you in the future. Unfortunately, most of us don't save enough money for retirement. 30-year-old today save $100. That could be worth $1,500 to them in retirement if they just put that money away. So it's playing the waiting game, thinking about what the long-term implications are is important.
A lot of times I'll go shopping, pick up a few things, maybe four or five things, and then by the time I get to the register, I'm like, no, I don't need all this, and I'll put three or four things back.
Good for you.
It's more, I think, guilt for me. I feel like I really don't need this.
There's nothing wrong with a little guilt.
Well, I always shop for needing, not for wanting.
There you go.
I only shop based on need.
That's a smart way to do it. Unfortunately, this time of year, we're susceptible to ads. We're susceptible to people buying, you know, see everybody buying stuff. We want to get in the spirit of buying stuff. It's the worst time of year people wreck their credit this time of year.
Now, here's something that I think is strange because it's something that people, 99% of people will actually be doing. And you say to avoid sales, 99% of people right now are shopping because of sales. Explain that.
Yeah, well, the sales are always there. Now, we see these deep discounts, you know, like Black Friday. There's oftentimes some good deals. But during the regular course of the year, there's sales all over the place. And oftentimes what we see is that stores jack up the price just to reduce it. If you're looking at 20, 30% off, that's no big deal. And, you know, one of the problems is if your spouse comes home and says, honey, I saved you all this money because we had to save 30, 40%, you really probably didn't save all that much. So look at sales with some skepticism because they're generally always there.
All right, so tell me a little bit about counting up how much you make an hour. Why is that important?
Well, if you translate into how much you make an hour into what it's going to cost, you're making $25 an hour, all right? That's $200 a day. If you're going to spend $200, you got to work all day to buy this one thing for $200. So think about what you make an hour, think about what you make a day, translate into what this purchase costs, and you'll think twice about buying it.
Wow, it's like calorie counting. If you pay attention to everything you eat, you're most likely not going to pick up that donut.
Exactly.
Once you really pay attention to everything you've eaten that day. Wow, that makes sense, though.
Yep, you know,
you don't think about money that way, but it's important.
It is very important.
All right, thank you so much, Joe. I appreciate it.
Good to be here,
Always
Kristen.
A pleasure.
Thank you.
Weather?